Now for some corporate stories, Bank of the Philippine Islands seeking to enhance employee learning development. It launched today BPI University, which it said will foster a stronger culture of learning and growth among its employees. The initiative takes on physical and digital platforms, which will provide employees with training tools and resources. The lender says BPI University will help solidify its position as an employer of choice. Also from the Ayala Group, Globe Business boosts its partnership with a nonprofit group for digital innovation. The telco giant says the tie-up with Livable Cities Philippines will push for digital transformation of public services across the country. The improved cooperation will see Globe conducting more workshops with LCC to share best practices, innovative solutions, and appropriate technologies to support local government units in the Philippines. Philippine Finance Chief Ralph Recto sees the Senate's ratification of the country's participation in the Convention on Mutual Administrative Assistance in Tax Matters as Manila's newest weapon against tax evasion. The MAAC is a comprehensive multilateral instrument developed by the OECD and the Council of Europe. It has been signed by 147 countries and ratified by over 100. Recto said the MMAC would significantly improve tax administration as it gives government access to data exchange, assessment, and enforcement tools. It will also allow the Philippines access to tax information of other jurisdictions. The executive order banning all POGOs will be issued in 2 weeks. This is according to the executive director of the Presidential Anti-Organized Crime Commission, Gilbert Cruz. Cruz says the definition of terms has already been finalized, and the only aspect that requires fine-tuning is the operational concept and how the executive order will be disseminated. President Marcos ordered a total ban on POGOs during his third State of the Nation address last July. The move is expected to displace over 27,000 workers, but the Department of Labor has vowed to provide assistance to them.
Pope Francis visits Singapore's parliament on day two of his visit to the city-state. He was welcomed by Singapore's President Tharman Shanmugaratnam, as well as members of parliament and leaders of local Catholic Church. The pontiff was presented with a specially grown orchid, the national flower of Singapore that is named after him. This is the last stop in the Pope's grand 12-day Asia-Pacific tour, the longest trip of his papacy. Republican presidential nominee and former U.S. President Donald Trump looking at another debate against his rival, Kamala Harris. Trump said he enjoyed a showdown in Philadelphia. But as it stands, there are no plans for another debate between the two.
We had a great debate. We had great poll numbers on the debate. And we enjoyed it. I hope she enjoyed it too, but I enjoyed it. And, we're looking at it, but... You know, when you win, you don't really necessarily have to do it a second time. So we'll see. But I thought we had a great debate last night. I would do NBC. I'd do Fox, too. But right now we have to determine whether or not we even want to do it.